1, 2, testing. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, test. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, testing. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Just trying to get this mic set up.
Does the Baron have a name?
No, but it has a quote from Shimizini in it.
Oh, tell us.
Walk on air against your better judgment.
My name is Gino Lupari from Maharafelt in County Derry. I'm one of the founder members of Four Men and a Dog. I first heard Irish music when I was third year in school at St. Pius the 10th School. And it was the trip to Sligo on an LP, if I'm sure your listeners and viewers will know what it was, a long playing record. And we had to write an essay on this piece of music. But I was so enthralled with the music that I asked my English teacher, could I have the record? And she said, yes, you didn't need it anymore. So I played this trip to Sligo all the time. And then I had to go to work for my uncle. My uncle was a marble setter. And I was serving my time in the terrazzo, which my family do, terrazzo and marble. And we were working in Bundoran. And I was 14, 15. And my uncle had his holidays booked to go back home to Italy. And he asked me, would I stay and work by myself? And I said, yeah, sure, you know. And the guy that I worked for said, as a present, he took me to Fitzgerald's music shop and bought me a Byron. And after that, it was downhill. I met Cathal Hayden when he was 14, 15, and I was about 17, in a pub in Maharafelt, and that is over 40-odd years ago. So Cathal and I started playing together. I was only a very, very amateur player, and some would say still am. But Cathal at that stage had won about 10 All-Irelands on the banjo and was a rising star in traditional music. I went to America, and then I came home one day and I was walking up the street and I met Cathal. And we, oh, come on, we'll go out and play a tune tonight. And we clicked. It was just when I saw the Byron, I said, I know I can play that. I can play that. We've been playing tunes ever since. When we first started the first album, Barking Mad, there was Mick Daly, Brian McGrath, banjo and piano, Donald Murphy, who was the youngest, Cathal and myself. None of us realised how quickly it would go, how the legs it had. You know, immediately we won Folk Roots Album of the Year, first Irish band and only Irish band to do. And Brian had just married and he didn't want to commit to it. And Mick never wanted to tour. He just wanted to do a few gigs. I says, I know who we'll get. We'll get Kevin Doherty. And Cathal said, and I'll ring Jerry O'Connor. So then, you know, the next thing was America and Canada and Europe. We were due to go to Hong Kong. And we had management at the time. And he says, lads, there's an offer of a gig in Hong Kong. There's an offer of a gig in Blackpool. And there's an offer of a gig in Haugesund in Norway. And I says, oh God, the handy one is Blackpool, like, really? And then they said, and the manager at the time said, but the gig in Haugesund is with the band. So Kevin and I knew who they were, and Jay knew who they were. I said, let's do that. And we went out, and we were sound checking. And on the first album, we recorded a song called Short Fat Fanny, which was one of Levon's songs from way before that. So they were all backstage in their tour bus and stuff and sitting. And I started singing Short Fat Fanny. So the other drummer with the band came in, Randy Charlante, and their producer, Aaron Howowitz. They came in to see our gig. Next thing, they said, you got to get Levon. So Levon came out, and Rick came out, and Garth came out. And I was singing Short Fat Fanny in front of the band. And we that night in Haugesund, Randy and Aaron, who went on to produce two of our albums, I think, in Woodstock, we recorded them in Levon's. Levon came down to my room with Rick, for a couple of drinks, and the minibar got rattled. Oh my God, it got hammered. And Levon's parting words to me after he gave me his phone number, he said, come to the barn in Woodstock. It never did muddy water any harm. I'd go in and see Levon in the morning, and you know, he'd be in his dressing gown and say, another day for the good guys. You know, he didn't have to get dressed. And Garth would come in. He was just enthralled with the Bowron and the way Cahill and Jerry played the banjo and fiddle. We recorded a track called Sometime Samba, and it was done live with all the musicians in the place live. To look around and see Garth playing saxophone or organ on it, and Rick playing bass or singing harmonies on Jofi Spoke's Kevin songs, it's a surreal moment. Tonight you're going to see Donald Murphy, Kevin Doherty, Stephen Hayden, Cal's brother, Cal Hayden, and myself. The band's divided into two schools of thought. Trad, Cal, Stephen, and Donald are trad down the line. Kevin and I don't have that traditional music background. We have. Kevin's a big Bob Dylan man. I'm a big a fan of the band, Levon and those boys. But then when it's mixed, as Levon says, when it's mixed, it's just an adult portion. Kevin was a budding songwriter in Donegal. Then the next thing, Mary Black recorded one of his songs, and then he became established as and all the songs that we have, except my song, are original. I still go back into the, you know, the roots of it. Thank you. bear.
Ladies and gentlemen, please make welcome four men and a dog.
Well, when I lived in London, this was just the mecca for it. Was great. And I remember the old, with the bar in the old room and the crack. Yeah, it was, I've had some what's the word, life-changing moments in this bar and in this place. And it's just, we never play anywhere else in London. We just feel like it's coming home.
Second home.
And we just, you know, we Roz and the staff we know, and Jerry, and we just, we're comfortable here and we don't need to be anywhere else. I'm sure we could do other gigs, but we don't want to do them.
This is Kevin Doherty from Bodhran in County Donegal.
Time hit, the town went crazy, drilling and banging all over the place, screaming with laughter and perspiration, digging deep, making haste. An angel swooped down over the city, cut the cord and dropped the bell. People lost a sense of pity. The flood moved on, the flood moved on, then the flood moved on and on and on, leaving nothing behind it but scratches. And the world took notice, and people traveled days for a little peace. The gates were shut, slammed and bolted. There was a baffling charge. Then the flood moved on. The flood moved on. The flood moved on and on, leaving nothing behind it but the scratches and the mud. Saddle, one of the many in a sea of green. You just hollow out your hearts and you paddle, a river of soul, a river of dreams. For the town woke up, the party was over, the tents were furled and the barkers were gone. They never looked back once over the shoulder. Then the flood moved on. The flood moved on. The flood moved on and on and on, leaving nothing behind it but the scratches and the mud. Do if you're under the saddle, one of the many in a sea of green.
You harden out your hearts and you paddle a river of soul, a river of dreams. For the town woke up, the party was over. Tents were furled and the barkers were gone, and they never looked back once over the shoulders. Then the flood moved on. Yes, the flood moved on. Yes, then the flood moved on and on and on, leaving nothing behind it but the scratch.
Very much. It's just so nice for us to be back playing in front of a crowd of people again. You know, the last gig we did before the whole lockdown was in Derry City with an 80-piece orchestra. And then 2 weeks later, the whole thing was shut down. So we got in there in the nick of time. It probably was a bit coincidental, yeah. But yeah, we've been pining for the day to get on stage again, and like we've done a few things, as most bands have, TV things and whatever, in front of empty rooms or whatever. So to see all these faces smiling up at us, you know,
they're not smiling.
There's a feel good factor. Well, they're smiling up at you.
Hey, smile, kid.
Right, is there any banjo players or banjo fans here? We happen to have a man here from a place called The Rock. If you've ever been to The Rock, you've been to a place called Hayden's Bar. It is right in the middle of it. And these two boys here, my right and left hand men, come from there. So next, we're going to feature Cathal Hayden here with a set of kind of sexy jigs called the Chapel Bell Jigs. So I hope you like these.
You'll have to forgive me as well. I'm not exactly just match fit. Thank you.
Logie, this is not for me. Kevin just needs a bit more Guinness in that monitor.
Kenneth?
I said Kevin. What's the frequency, Ken? Coming back to Hammersmith is just like coming back to see old friends, and it is, it's great, and we see such great friends here, Andy Martin and his wife, and Connor Griffin and his wife. We haven't seen Connor for such a long time, and we did cut our teeth in the Stag's Head. Man, left a few there too. He doesn't say much, but he's good. And the wonderful Bert, and that's when I first met Andy Martin 30 years ago. God, that was a long time ago.
Andy must have been small then.
He was about 11. But shit, he could drink pints when he was 11. So it's just a great pleasure to come and see all our friends and people that have been with us throughout all the years we've been playing music, and Mark and Sarah, and we played when they first met, and their son here is now, he's 6'11" or something, he's here too. So I'm going to pass you over to Kevin to sing.
This song is loosely based on a Seamus Heaney poem. And it was his version of an old Irish poem about a fella called the Mad Sweeney. And Sweeney was punished by a monk, apparently, and the monk turned him into a bird, and he was doomed to fly around Ireland for the rest of his life, which to me didn't sound like a bad idea. But in this version, the turning into the bird is actually of the person's own volition, faced with what we're all faced with, decided, in fact, I think I will turn myself into a bird and head off. Unfortunately, ends up in Sligo Butcher. It was close, but no cigar.
From chaos I was born, and when the glass falls from my hand, to chaos I'll return. The occupation is complete. I know there was resistance. See the soldiers on the street, I always keep my distance. Then to a small and sparkling stream, cold and clear and pleasing, I gather by the Hippocrene with both hands cupped. I am a rambling Irish man. God is not for knowing. So I cracked my head and up I flew, and I landed in a ruin. And I heard those armies clash at night, and I willed them all to settle. And I watched the great elk taking flight through the lake mist and the nettles. I sat upon a thorny bush somewhere outside Sligo, and from high upon that thorny bush, how I love this world so. I am a rambling Irishman. from chaos I was born. And when the glass falls from my hand, to chaos I will return. Was cautioned to surrender, this I could not do. I took my gun and I vanished. I have lost my wife and children, I've lost them surely, but I must go on. The frontiers are my prison. I have changed my name so often, I have lost my wife and children, but I've many friends, and some of them are with me. An old woman gave us shelter, kept us hidden in the garret, then the soldiers came. She died without a whisper. Oh, the wind is blowing through the graves, the wind is blowing. Freedom soon will come. Then we'll come from the shadow. Il me diront sin étoile, mais je n'ai pas peur. J'ai repris mon âme. J'ai changé 100 fois de nom. J'ai perdu femme et enfant, mais j'ai tant d'amis. J'ai la France entière. Dans un grenier, pour la nuit nous en cacher, les Allemands l'ont pris. Il est mort sans surprise. Oh, the wind is blowing, through the graves the wind is blowing, freedom soon will come. Then we'll come from the shadow. Thank you.
We'll be right back. How drunk are you? You're sitting on it.
Up you get.
Just absolutely. Ask my mate, I'm sweating. This is a song that we have been singing for a while. We had the good luck and out in Woodstock to meet the band, Levon Helm and Rick Danko and Gareth Hudson and all the boys, and we used to hang out with them. And we'll sing this song for Connor and Andy and his lovely wife, Patina. Go out of yonder, east in the valley. Look downtown, there's a rumble in the alley. Oh, you don't know the shit I'm in. Has anybody seen my lady? Just living alone, gonna drive me crazy. Oh, you don't know the shit I'm in. I've just been down by the water, but I ain't gonna jump in, no. Cause here I am looking for my lady. Can you tell me that that's where she's been? Oh, out of night, I spent seven. Now how in the world do you get to heaven? Days in the jailhouse for the crime of having no door. Now here I am back on the street for the crime of having nowhere to go. Save yourself now, I'll save your brother. Looks like it's one or the other. They start a ruckus. Look out, boys, they're trying to shock us. Oh, you don't know the shit
gentlemen, Gino Lupari.
Thank you. Oh. Well, we're going to round it all up. Listen, all together or not at all, never mind that shit. So we're going to round it all up. I think of a Noel's house party. But before we go, a round of applause, please, for Jerry Logue on the sound and production. Ruby Thank you so much for carrying all the drinks up. There's Ruby over there, her second week. William, we hope you enjoy your chocolate. Thank you for looking after so well. It's been a great pleasure to come and play for you. From Donegal on guitar and vocals, Monsieur Kevin Doherty.
Thank you.
On fiddle from the Rock, County Tyrone, Mr. Stephen Hayden. Ladies and gentlemen, the housewife's favourite, from Abbey Field on accordion, Mr. Donal Murphy. I just heard that. That's quite funny. On fiddle and banjo from the Rock County, Tyrone, Mr. Cal Hayden. Good night. It's been a great pleasure playing for you. Thank you so, so much for coming out to see live music. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Mahara Felt in County Derry, the man, the myth, the legend, Mr. Gino Lupari.
I'm gonna go get some more. Thank you.
Thank you.